हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन व्हाट इज द पावर सीरीज। एंड हाउ टू चेक द कन्वर्जेंस एंड डाइवर्जेंस ऑफ दिस पावर सीरीज। सो व्हाट इज द पावर सीरीज? बेसिकली इट इज अ सीरीज ऑफ द फॉर्म सी एन एक्स टू द पावर एन, वेयर एन इज वेरिंग फ्रॉम जीरो टू इन्फिनिटी। सो दिस इज सी नॉट प्लस सी वन एक्स प्लस सी टू एक्स स्क्वायर and so on up to c n x to the power n and so on. Here these c naught, c 1, c 2 till up to c n, these are the constants, and x is any real number. So you are having a series in the terms of powers of x. So that's why this is called power series. Now this is the first form, which is a power series about the center zero, right? So power series about the center A, this is given by this. It is Cn x minus a to the power n. So this is C naught plus C1 x minus a plus C2 x minus a whole square and so on Cn x minus a whole to the power n. So here this C naught, C1, C2 and so on Cn, these are constants, and we are having a series in the terms of powers of x minus a, right? So this is a power series about the center A. So now the next is to check the convergence or divergence of these type of series. Means we need to find out for what value of x the given power series converges or diverges, right? So in power series, the question is for what value of x does the power series converges or diverges, right? So we need to check the values of x for which this given series is convergent. Now just see with the help of an example. For example, let's suppose we are having a series of the form x to the power n, where n is varying from 0 to infinity. So this is 1 plus x plus x square and so on x to the power n and so on. Now clearly this is a GP series, right, with first term 1 and the common ratio as x. And by GP series test, we know that the given series is convergent only when the common ratio is mod of this is strictly less than 1. So it means whenever mod of x is less than 1. So this implies what? What is the interval? Right? This will become this. So, or you can say your x is belonging to the interval minus 1 to 1. For these value of x, this given series is convergent and it converges to a upon 1 minus r, which is 1 upon 1 minus x. So here this is the right hand side, we are having a series and we say that this series is converging to 1 upon 1 minus x provided mod of x is strictly less than 1. So this is a series, power series, for these values of x this series is convergent and it converges to this function 1 upon 1 minus x. Now let's suppose we are having a power series of the form minus 1 to the power n x to the power n by n, where n is varying from 1 to infinity. So in this question we need to find out those values of x for which this power series is convergent. Now just see, x may be negative, x may be positive, so this series has either positive sign or negative sign, so we don't know, it depends on the value of x. Since till now we have done all the tests which are applicable to only positive term series, except the test alternating series test, but in case of alternating series test the sign is this and rest the terms should be positive. So an should be positive, decreasing, and nth term is approaching to zero, only then by alternating series test, we can say that the series is convergent, right? So here this is a sign again, we don't know what is the value of x, whether it is positive or negative. So we cannot apply alternating series test over here. Okay, so we need to check the behavior of this series by converting it into positive term series, and that will be done with the help of taking mod of it, right? So we first of all consider the mod of this series, right? Now the terms are positive. Now we can apply any test which is applicable to positive term series, and we can check the behavior of this series. Now the next question is, we need to find out the values of x for which this given series is convergent absolutely. We have taken the absolutes, we have taken the mode. So we will check in this case for what value of x this given series is converging absolutely. Now we will apply either ratio test or nth root test, because in these two tests we have some conditions that the limit n going to infinity a n plus 1 upon a n, say it is L. If this L is less than 1, this implies series is always convergent. If it is greater than 1, then this implies series is always divergent. And for equal to 1, this test fails. The same with the case of nth root test. In that case, we will find out the limit of the nth root. Say it is L. Again, if L is less than 1, it is convergent, greater than 1, divergent, and equal to 1, test fail. So we will apply these two tests to check the behavior of the power series, because only in these two tests we will get some conditions on the values of x, right? So we will get some interval, we will get some values of x for which the given series is convergent. Now just see, after applying ratio test, what will we get? When we apply ratio test, what will we have? The limit n going to infinity of n plus 1th upon nth term, this comes out to be x to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1 into n upon x to the power n mod. So after simplifying, we have this is this. Now this limit is 1, right? And we know that whenever this ratio is strictly less than 1, so we use this thing that this is strictly less than 1. So from here, what we have? From here, we get mod of x is strictly less than 1. Right? So we get some values of x for which this given series converges absolutely. Right? For these values of x, this given series is convergent and it converges absolutely. For the same values of x, the original series is also convergent, because we know that whenever a series converges absolutely, the original series is also convergent by absolute convergence test. So for these values of x, this series is also convergent, right? So we have this as an interval. You just open mod of x, you will have this is this. So we can write this as, whenever our x is belonging to minus 1 to 1, this series converging absolutely. But in case of ratio test, whenever this limit is exactly 1, we can't see anything. Series may or may not be convergent. So that is the case. Now just see, what is this case? This is the case whenever mod of x, which is a limit by using the limit ratio test, whenever this limit is 1, we don't know whether the series is convergent or not. Now this means our x is either 1 or it is minus 1. So we will substitute x to be 1, right? So what is the series? It will be minus 1 to the power n x 1 to the power n by n. In the given series, we will substitute the value of x to be 1 and we will have a series. Now we check the behavior of this series, whether it is convergent or not. right? So we need to check the behavior of this series when we put x to be 1. Okay, now just see, first of all we check its mod, so we consider the mod of it. This is nothing but 1 by n series, and clearly this series is divergent by p series test, right? So since this series is divergent by p series test, it means this series is not convergent absolutely. Okay, so this implies what? The given series minus 1 to the power n by n does not converge absolutely. So when your series is not convergent absolutely, we are not sure about the behavior of the series. We need to check without its mod. So now we consider the series without mod. So when we consider the series without mod, this is an alternating series, right? So when you apply alternating series test, what are your ans? This is 1 by n. Clearly this is greater than 0 for every n varying from 1, 2, 3 and so on. Secondly, we know that n is always less than n plus 1. So 1 over n will be greater than 1 over n plus 1. So this implies an is decreasing. Number 3, the limit of n going to infinity of an, which is 1 by n and which is 0 when you put n tending to infinity. So all these three conditions are satisfied. All the three conditions of alternating series test are satisfied. So therefore the given series minus 1 to the power n by n, this is convergent. So whenever a series with mod is not convergent but without mod convergent, then this is said to be conditional convergence. So this series is convergent conditionally. So therefore for x is equal to 1, this given series is converging conditionally. Now we need to check for x is equal to minus 1. So now you just substitute the value of x to be minus 1 in the given series. What will we have? We have this. This is what? This is 1 by n. And this is divergent by p series test. So neither our series is converging absolutely nor conditionally. Okay. Now combine all these points. What are these points? Now first of all, this interval where the series converging absolutely. Now at the end points, for x is equal to 1, the series is not converging absolutely, however it is converging conditionally. And for x is equal to minus 1, the series is not convergent. So what is the interval of absolute convergence? What is the interval of absolute convergence? What does it mean? It means write down the those values of x for which the series is convergent absolutely. Now series is convergent absolutely on the interval minus 1 to 1, right? So this will become the interval of absolute convergence. Now the next is conditional convergence. So in this problem we have seen that the series converges conditionally for x is equal to 1. So conditionally convergence exists only at one point, which is x is equal to 1. So what will be the interval of convergence? Interval of convergence means those values of x for which the series without mod is convergent. So without mod, it is converging on this interval. It is also convergent on 1. It is convergent on all those values where absolute convergence occurs, because absolute convergence implies the convergence of the series. So this will become the interval of the convergence of the series. So interval of convergence, it is those points of x for which the given series converges without mod, without taking mod, right? So this is an interval. For these values of x, our series is convergent, right? The next is the radius of convergence. Now, what is the radius of convergence? Radius of convergence is basically in the form of interval, it will be mod of x minus a less than r. This r number is said to be the radius of the convergence, right? And here a is the center. Now in this question, just see that here your a is 0, the center is 0, and mod of x is less than 1. So when you compare with this definition, right, your a is 0 and mod of x is less than 1. So what will be the radius of convergence? It is 1, right? Basically, what is interval of convergence? Our x lying between minus 1 and plus 1, for this interval our series is convergent, right? So the max distance is 2. So what is the radius? Radius is 1, right? So this is a way to find out. You just find out those values of x for which this condition hold. Mod of x minus a should be less than r. Then this r is said to be the radius of convergence, right? The form is always this one. So for this form, the coefficient of x should be 1. If it is not 1, you just divide by the constant term, right, both side, and make it 1 over here. And then after simplifying, whatever the value of r is here, that is become the radius of convergence. Okay, so this is the radius of convergence, this is the interval of convergence, absolute and conditional. Okay, so what type of problem we have in case of power series? We have, for what value of x does the series, does the power series, let's suppose we are having a series minus 1 to the power n into n factorial into x to the power n, for what value of x, value or values of x does the series this converges absolutely or conditionally? Also find the sum, find the interval of convergence and the radius of convergence, right? So this type of problem may be asked in case of power series. So what is our power series? This is minus 1 to the power n, n factorial x to the power n. So first of all, we apply the ratio test. This is a rule. First apply the ratio test and find out the condition on the values of x for which the given series is convergent. Now for ratio test, we need positive terms. So we will take mod. So what we have, this is n plus 1 factorial upon x into x to the power n plus 1 divided by n factorial into x to the power n, right? This is what, when you put n tending to infinity, it is infinity. It does not depend upon the value of x. In every case, it is infinity. So what we have, this infinity is strictly greater than 1. So this implies the series diverges for all values of x, right, except at x is equal to 0, because when you put x to be 0, the given series is 0, it is 0 plus 0 plus 0, and clearly this series is convergent and converges to 0, right? So the given series is always divergent because its nth term, n plus 1th term, is greater than nth term, right? This nth term is always greater than nth term. It means its nth term is never going to zero. So by nth term divergent is the given series is divergent. So it is not convergent except at the point zero. So now, what will be the interval of absolute convergence, conditional convergence, interval of convergence, and radius of convergence in this case? Now, since the series is not convergent for all x belonging to, so here your series is convergent, the given series is convergent only at x is equal to 0. So what will be the interval of absolute convergence? That is only at a point x is equal to 0. So what is the interval of convergence? Again, we are not having any interval, but only one point, which is x is equal to 0. Is there any conditional convergence? No. There is no point, so none. Kisi point par aisa nahi hai. There is no point where the series converges, but with mod it is not converging. So there is no point where we have a conditional convergence. Now, what is the radius of convergence? Since we are not having any interval, it is just only a one point, so radius of convergence will be 0. So this is the answer of this question, right? For what value of x the given series is converging absolutely? For this value of x, the given series is absolute convergent. For this value of x, the given series is convergent. There is no point where the series converging conditionally. Since we are not having any interval, so the radius of the convergence will be 0. Now just see one more example. Let's suppose we need to find out for what values of x does the series x to the power n over n factorial converges absolutely or conditionally . Also find the interval of convergence and radius of convergence. Now just see the solution of it. The given series is x to the power n over n factorial. So first of all, we apply the ratio test. We find out the limit of n plus 1th and nth term. Now we will have, this is x to the power n plus 1 upon n plus 1 factorial into the reciprocal of this, which is n factorial upon x to the power n. This is cancel out, this is cancel out. We left with this. We know that the given series is convergent if this ratio is strictly less than 1. Now what is the value of this limit? Since it is x to the power x by n plus 1, when you put n tending to infinity, you will have this is 0, which is always less than 1, independent of the value of x. Whatever you put the value of x, this limit is always less than 1. It means the given series is convergent absolutely for all x belonging to R, right? R means real numbers, right? It's a symbol of for all. It's a symbol of belongs, right? So the given series is convergent absolutely for all x belonging to the real numbers, means your x belongs to the interval minus infinity to infinity. So what is your interval of absolute convergence? It is minus infinity to infinity. Interval of convergence, it is same as that minus infinity to infinity. What is the radius? Since interval is minus infinity to infinity, so radius of convergence will be infinity. Is there any point where the series is not converging absolutely but without mode it is convergent? No point. So conditionally convergence, none. So this is the answer of this question. Now just see one more example. Let's suppose we need to find out for what value of x, sorry, here it is minus, for what value of x this given series is convergent absolutely, conditionally, also find interval and radius. So again we apply ratio test. So what will we have? The limit of n plus 1th and nth term by taking mod. So when you put n plus 1, so this is 2n plus 1 plus 1 will become 2n plus 3, divide by n plus 1 to the power 3 by 2 into n to the power 3 by 2, 4x minus 5 to the power 2n plus 1. So what will we have? We have 4 minus x to the power this n to the power 3 by 2. If you take n to the power 3 by 2 common in the denominator, we will have this thing. It will be cancelled out. So this limit is 1. So we know that by ratio test, whenever this limit is strictly less than 1, the series is convergent. So from here, what we have? We have this is less than 1, which is same as that 4x minus 5 is less than 1. This mod is less than 1. Now to find out the radius of convergence, this coefficient should be 1. So we have to divide by 4 to both sides. So we will have, so mod of x minus a, this is the center, and this r, this is the radius. So here the radius of convergence is 1 by 4. And what is the interval? You just simplify this. From here what we have? We get this as an interval. This is the interval, this is the radius. Now we need to check at the end points whether the series is convergent at 1 or not, or 3 by 2 or not. So we put x to be 1. So when we put x to be 1, 4x minus 5, 4 into 1 minus 5 to the power 2n plus 1, divide by n to the power 3 by 2, this will become minus 1 to the power 2n plus 1, divide by n to the power 3 by 2. Since this is negative, so we will have this is minus 1 to the power, minus 1 upon n to the power 3 by 2. So first we consider its mod. When you take its mod, we will have this series. Clearly this series is convergent by P series test. So this series, this implies what? The given series is convergent absolutely for x is equal to 1. Now check at the point x is equal to 3 by 2. When you put x to be 3 by 2, again this is a series 1 over n to the power 3 by 2, which is convergent by p series test. So therefore, again the given series converges absolutely at x is equal to 3 by 2. So what is the interval of absolute convergence? Now it will become not open, but it will become closed going from 1 to 3 by 2, because at x is equal to 1 series is absolute convergent, at x is equal to 3 by 2 it converges absolutely, and for these values of x it is already given that this series is converging absolutely. So the interval of absolute convergence is this. So what is conditional convergence over here? There is no point where the series converging conditionally, so we write down none. What is the interval of convergence? This is a union of these two. The interval of absolute convergence, union conditional convergence, where this is same as that absolute one. And what is the radius? The radius of convergence is 1 by 4. Right? This is the radius of convergence, which is 1 by 4. Okay, now just see one more example. Let's suppose you need to check the behavior of the series x plus pi to the power n divided by square root of n. So we apply ratio test first by taking mod. We find out the limit of n plus 1th upon nth term. This is what? This is x plus pi to the power n plus 1 divided by square root of n plus 1 into square root of n x plus pi to the power n and mod. This limit is 1. So we will have mod of x plus pi. This, whenever this limit is strictly less than 1, the given series is convergent absolutely. Now what is the radius of convergence? Radius of convergence is 1. Right? Now we need to check the value at the endpoints. Now first of all, find out the endpoints. Just simplify this and find out the interval. Now this implies your x is lying between minus pi minus 1 and 1 minus pi. So this is the interval of convergence, absolute convergence. What now we need to check at the endpoints, what will happen when you put x to be minus pi minus 1 in the given series? When you put x to be minus pi minus 1, we have the series is minus 1 to the power n over square root of n. So we first consider its mod. This is 1 over square root of n. This is divergent by p series test. So the series is not converging absolutely. Now we need to check the behavior of the series without mod. Now we can apply alternating series test. The terms are 1 by n. Clearly this is positive. We know that n is less than n plus 1, so 1 over n is greater than 1 over n plus 1, so this is decreasing, and the limit n approaching to infinity of 1 over square root of n, right, this is going to 0 since all the three conditions are satisfied. So this implies your series is convergent at x is equal to minus pi minus 1 by alternating series test. So without mod it is divergent, but with without mod it is convergent by alternating series test, and with mod it is divergent. So this implies this series converges conditionally, right? So for this value of x, the given series is convergent conditionally, not absolutely but conditionally. Now we need to check at x is equal to 1 minus pi. So when you put x to be 1 minus pi, what is the series? The series is 1 over square root of n, and this is divergent by p series test. So for this value of x, neither your series converging conditionally nor absolutely, right? So now just club all these things. What is the interval of absolute convergence? Now what is the interval of absolute convergence? This one, the point is not your series is not converging absolutely at this point as well as at this point, so this will remain the interval of convergence. So what is the interval of absolute convergence? This is an open interval, minus 1 minus pi to 1 minus pi. Now what is interval of convergence? Since the conditional convergence exists at a point at x is equal to minus 1 minus pi, now do you take the union of these two? So we will have the interval of convergence is minus 1 minus pi close from this side, comma 1 minus pi open from this side. Okay, so this is the interval of convergence, which is a union of these two. Now what is the radius of convergence? The radius of convergence is 1 with center A, this minus pi. So radius of convergence is 1. So this is the answer.